Before we move on, I noticed that there's quite a few people still standing at the back of the room. We do have a section of seating that is available here as you're facing the stage to the right. So I'm just going to give everybody a minute to head on over and grab a seat, because I don't want you standing the whole ceremony if we don't have to. Be much more comfortable. And how are we doing for seats over there? Are there still some left or no? They all gone? Okay, and we do have probably about 20 or so more seats over here. And we do have a few more in this section here. So if you want to make your way over, that would be great. Thank you, everybody, for your patience. And as we are getting settled here, I'd just like to call everybody's attention to the screens on either side of the stage. We will now be hosting or showing our This Is the Moment video, which encapsulates your experiences at Brock University. So please draw your attention to the screen for this brief video.
This is the moment that defines what happens next. This is the moment you knew what you wanted. And this is the moment you got it. This is the moment you said goodbye. And this is the moment you missed. This is the moment the distance was surprisingly short. And this is the moment the distance was painfully long. This is the moment you opened the door to a new house. And this is the moment it became a home. This is the moment you took some notes. This is the moment you took it all in. This is the moment you fell in love. And this is the moment you fell asleep. This is the moment she told you to take a hike. And this is the moment you did. This is the moment you reached for new heights. And this is the moment you reached new land. This is the moment you learned something new. And this is the moment you had to remember it. This is the moment you were overwhelmed. This is the moment you overachieved. This is the moment you stopped. This is the moment you caught your breath. And this is the moment it was taken away. This is the moment you took the night. And this is the moment you took the stage. This is the moment you say you'll never forget. This is the moment they won't let you. This is the moment you wondered how you would do it. This is the moment you realized why you are here. This is your proudest moment. This is their proudest moment. This is the moment you realize the importance of this moment. And this is the moment that defines what happens next.
And to share some memories and photos of your experiences today for this Brock moment, we encourage you to visit the Brock University official Facebook page and tag your photos to share with your friends. The faculty procession will be beginning momentarily, so we ask that you please stand at the rising of the fanfare.
Thank you. I declare the 99th convocation for the conferring of degrees and certificates in session. Chancellor Chichu, President Lightstone, Trustee Zimmerman, Senate Chair Henderson, honored guest Dr. Abu Elish, platform guests, graduating students, parents, and friends. Welcome to Brock University's Spring Convocation, a time of celebration for our students, families, and friends. It is my pleasure this afternoon to introduce from the Chancellor's procession, Dr. Shirley Chichu, Chancellor of Brock University, Dr. Jack Lightstone, Vice Chancellor and President of Brock University, Ms. Elizabeth Zimmerman, Trustee, Brock University Board of Trustees, Dr. Izzeldine Abu Elish, this afternoon's honorary degree recipient, Dr. Scott Henderson, Mace Bearer and Chair of Brock University Senate, Dr. Ingrid Makis, Department of Political Science, Dr. Carol Merriam, Dean, Faculty of Humanities, Mr. Brian Hutchings, Vice President, Administration, Dr. Thomas Dunk, Dean, Faculty of Social Sciences, Dr. Greg Finn, Acting Provost and Vice President, Academic, Dr. Michael Pliley, Dean, Faculty of Graduate Studies, Dr. Geoff Mercier, Associate Vice President, Research, Dr. Anna Lathrop, Vice Provost, Teaching, Learning, and Student Success. And joining them on stage are university senators, faculty, staff, and student representatives from across the university. I would ask them to also please stand together and be recognized with their colleagues. Please be seated. I now invite Chancellor Chichu to deliver words of welcome.
I want to acknowledge the elders and the traditional territories of many nations that I am standing on. I am honored to be part of this ceremony. President Lightstone, Board Chair Sue, Senate Chair Henderson, trustees and senators, senior administrators, faculty and staff of Brock University, family and friends of the graduates, and especially the graduates. It is my privilege to welcome you to this graduation award ceremony. A graduation ceremony is one of the most memorable events in our lives because you have come to the end of a long journey. This ceremony tells you and your families that you are now prepared to begin your life to achieve future goals. Now that you will walk with the sharks, I encourage you to use all the knowledge you learned and speak up for those who cannot speak. Stand beside them and be their light, their rock, as there are so many young people in this country that are standing in the dark. Fight for what is good and fight for what can be changed during your generation. And always be part of the good and fight for the world you want to live with your own families. Racism is one of the biggest things we have to try and overcome. And I suggest to you to talk to anyone, any race, and you might be surprised that you will find some common ground. If you do this, come from an open mind and an open heart, and you will develop relationships that will take your knowledge to new heights. And this world needs that. And we only talk to people we know, we become more divided, and it gets harder to make this world a better place. No matter what you do in life, someone is always watching. Your younger brother or your younger sister, and they want to do what their older siblings are doing. If you pick up a young child's ball and give it to him, you become a role model for that child, and he will continue to watch what his role model is doing. We all have responsibilities in life, and one of them is that you walk in this world leading others to follow. You are in control of your own destinies. Take any opportunity that is available to generate your own source of income, wealth. This opportunity can lead you to the end of a rainbow and bring you happiness and a rewarding life, and you will reach your goals if you put 100% of yourself into it. I have learned over my career, the only way I achieve my goals is to work hard and invest in myself, because no one else will. Being true to yourself brings happiness and success. There is a sense of unexplainable energy in this room. Like every parent in this place knows that feeling as they sit here at your graduation. The feeling vibrates from every part of your body, and it's totally indescribable. So if your parents do not tell you how they feel, it's because they can't. So graduates, obviously we're all very proud of you, but let's give a big hand for your proud parents, families, friends, and professors, because this is their day too. Miigwech.
It is my pleasure to introduce Ms. Elizabeth Zimmerman, member of the Board of Trustees, who will present the Spirit of Brock Medals. Ms. Zimmerman has served on the board since 2015 and is currently a member of the Governance Nominating Committee and the Financial Planning and Investment Committee. She is also the Executive Director of the YWCA Niagara Region, a nonprofit organization working with homeless women and their families, providing emergency shelter, transitional supportive housing, and ongoing support services. She has worked for over 20 years in the nonprofit human services sector. In addition to serving as chair of the Niagara Poverty Reduction Network, she is actively involved in various committees throughout the Niagara region to help raise awareness of these important issues and to implement change. Please join me in welcoming Ms. Elizabeth Zimmerman.
Good afternoon, Dr. Lightstone, Chancellor Chicho, honored guests, faculty, staff, and graduates. The Board of Trustees recognizes the commitment, dedication, and sacrifice that it takes to become a graduate of Brock University. We take great pride in your achievements and share with you and your family in the celebration of your success. As a part of this celebration, the Board of Trustees created a unique award in order to pay tribute to the outstanding achievements and contributions of graduating students. During this spring convocation, the Board of Trustees Spirit of Brock Medal will be awarded to an undergraduate and graduate student who best exemplify the spirit of Sir Isaac Brock. Students who demonstrate any one or more of the qualities of leadership, courage, innovation, inspiration, and community involvement have been recommended to receive the award by their respective faculty dean. Today, I have the honor to present the Board of Trustees Spirit of Brock Medal to Faculty of Social Science undergraduate student Rebecca Lapour. And Faculty of Social Sciences graduate student Antwi Bozaiko. So yes, if Rebecca and Antwi, please come forward to receive your awards. Congratulations to both of you. So Rebecca exemplifies the spirit of Brock through dedicated leadership and community involvement, as well as a strong commitment to her field of study, speech and language sciences. Rebecca is a four-year member of the Brock Linguistics Network Executive. She began as a first-year representative and completed her tenure this past year as president. Her work included setting up events for students and faculty and organizing fundraisers for worthy causes, including the annual Bowling for Smiles event to raise money for Operation Smile, an organization that provides free cleft palate surgeries to underprivileged children. Rebecca's leadership extends beyond her own department to the university community as a member of the Brock Leaders Citizenship Society and also to Future Badgers through her role as a Smart Start team member and a frequent student ambassador at Brock Open House and the Ontario Universities Fair. Rebecca devotes time and energy to causes ranging from literacy to Alzheimer's to breaking barriers for physical disabilities. She's also the co-founder of Pennies for Food, raising money for the St. Matthew's House Food Bank. Since March 2009, she has raised more than $5,000. That's more than 500,000 pennies. And she's done all of this while maintaining an overall average of 91%. Rebecca exhibits all of the qualities most worthy of a Board of Trustees Spirit of Brock Medal recipient, says Tom Farrell, Chair of the Department of Applied Linguistics. She's an exceptional student and individual who has demonstrated outstanding leadership and contributed significantly to Brock University and the broader community. Congratulations, Rebecca. Entwi Bosayako, a student in the Masters of Political Science program, has exemplified the spirit of Brock through his innovation and community involvement, especially through his work with Positive Living Niagara, an organization that provides support, education, and advocacy to persons affected by HIV and AIDS in the Niagara region. Entwi began volunteering with Positive Living Niagara last summer under Winnie Murrow-Zambedzi, the organization's education and support coordinator in charge of the African, Caribbean, and Black community. She soon recognized Entwi as a true change agent and a global citizen who is committed to the social transformation of the lives of HIV/AIDS clients, who exhibits sterling leadership, courage, and dedicated community service in the multiple roles that he performs in our organization. In addition to serving on the organization's planning committee, delivering medication, and transporting clients to medical appointments, Entwi also promptly applied his skills as a researcher and innovator to create a database detailing the health and social profile of Positive Living Niagara clients. This means the organization can now ensure that services are directed to areas most in need. Beyond his community service, Entwi is an accomplished Brock graduate student. Indeed, a paper he completed for one of his graduate courses and subsequently published has since been added to the recommended reading list for that course, a testament to Entwi's understanding of complex issues and surely the first of many significant contributions to his field. Once again, please join me in congratulating both Rebecca and Entwi.
Senate Chair Henderson, Trustee Zimmerman, Dr. Honorad Abu-Elesh, faculty and staff of Brock University, friends and family of the graduates, welcome. And to you graduates, a very special welcome indeed. I want to begin, as did our Chancellor, by acknowledging and honoring the ancestors of those on whose traditional lands we gather today. Brock University is located along what today is known as the Bruce Trail, on traditional shared territory of the Anishinaabe, Haudenosaunee, and Attawandaron. Today we acknowledge First Nation, Métis, and Inuit peoples, and all Indigenous peoples who have joined us for this convocation. Now, graduates, you all look very subdued. Are you happy to be graduating? Family and friends of the graduates, are you happy that they are graduating? Now, you may be happy that you're here, but as you can hear from the roar that came from your family and friends, they are more relieved than you are. But they are also very proud of you, and I'm sure that that comes through in the roar that you've heard from behind you. And you should be proud of yourselves for all the hard work that brought you to the success that's represented in the ritual that you are going through today. And you should also know that those of us on the stage who represent the entirety of the faculty and staff at Brock University, we too share in the joy that your family and friends share today, and that you, I'm sure, feel as well, despite your lukewarm reaction to my request, because today represents not only the culmination of your work, but in the most real sense, your graduation today represents the culmination of our work as well. So we share in the joy that I'm sure you feel, even though you didn't express it very clearly, and that your family and friends certainly expressed with gusto. Now, graduation seems like a very formal and ritualized event, and indeed it is. After all, the platform party parades in to the strains of classical music, Handel, I believe. And we're all dressed, and you're all dressed, in the height of fashion for the 16th century. But despite the ritual and formal aspects of the day, above all, today is a day of celebration. And I want everyone in this hall to know that it's all right to clap and hoot and holler and whistle and stamp your feet to celebrate and recognize the achievements of your friend or your loved one as he or she crosses the stage to receive his or her diploma or degree. And to get us all in the right mood, I would like to have a practice run on the count of three. One, two, three. Enjoy convocation.
Madam Chancellor and honored guests, I am deeply honored to be able to introduce Dr. Izzeldin Abu-Laish, an internationally renowned physician, researcher, professor, author, educator, public speaker, and the thread that ties all these together, an activist for peace and the protection of human rights. In his autobiography, I Shall Not Hate, published in 2010 and translated into 23 languages, Dr. Abu-Laish documents his experiences growing up as a Palestinian and living in a refugee camp in the Gaza Strip, witnessing firsthand the effects of poverty, disease, and violence, including what seems an insurmountable tragedy, losing three of his daughters and his niece in the bombing of his home during the Gaza War in 2009. In honor of them, he founded Daughters for Life, a Canadian organization devoted to advancing the health and education of women and girls in the Middle East. In his autobiography, he writes movingly about the importance of strong women in his life and how removing barriers for women and girls is essential to resolving conflict in the Middle East and around the world. The book is difficult to read, but the message is powerful and hopeful. Turn away from hatred and revenge towards tolerance and building bridges. Dr. Abu Laish has received numerous awards across many countries for his work, including nominations for the Nobel Peace Prize and recognition from presidents and prime ministers. These accolades come from important political figures and key public institutions, which Dr. Abu Laish recognizes as important vehicles for change. Perhaps most importantly, however, he compels us to recognize that the simple, everyday acts of ordinary people are as significant, or perhaps more significant, for real change. At the end of his book, he talks about moving to Toronto with his children. One of the first things he and his neighbors did was remove part of the fence so the children could run back and forth and play freely. He says there is much for us to think about in this act. This image has struck with me. It reminds me that basic, human, meaningful interactions begin in childhood. It reminds me, as a political theorist and as a mother of two daughters, that the lessons we provide our children are the ones that will carry us all forward into our shared futures. In the spirit of Gandhi, Martin Luther King, and Nelson Mandela, this kind of wisdom makes Dr. Abu Laish a great philosopher of justice as well as a peace activist. Madam Chancellor, I have the honor to present Dr. Izzeldin Abu Laish to receive at your hands the degree of Doctor of Laws honoris causa.
Dr. Izzeldin Abu Laish, I admit you to the degree Doctor of Laws honoris causa and grant you all the rights, privileges, and insignia of pretending thereto.
Madam Chancellor and honored guests, I take pleasure in calling on Dr. Abu Laish to deliver the convocation address.
Thank you so much, Chancellor, Chichu, President Lightstone, honored guests, faculty and staff, ladies and gentlemen. It's my great pleasure to have this honor from Brock University and speak to you and to your parents. I am so moved and thrilled at this moment because I missed this opportunity of celebrating my commencements at the different universities I graduated from, and my parents were not able to join me and to celebrate it. So today, I am celebrating with you. I am bringing my children to celebrate with me that they were not at that time, and to dedicate this honor to those who are not with me, to my beloved parents, my wife and my beloved daughters, and the innocent mothers and the children in this world who have no voice and no one is hearing or knowing about them. Let me start by congratulating you and your parents, your families, as you begin your professional life and career. It's a promising gathering with a strong belief in the presence of hope. Today reminds me, as I said, of my first day at the medical school in Cairo. I wanted to succeed. I wanted to graduate, to go back home, where my parents are waiting for me to celebrate and to help them and to make a change in their life. And my people who were waiting for me to help them, I want to share with you my life experience and life story. Because stories are not just stories. Stories, they have a meaning and are lessons to learn from. There are serious challenges facing us as individuals and the world in which we live. My life as a Palestinian refugee was a war. I faced many challenges, but as life increased my aches, my pain and suffering, at the same time, life amplified my maturity, awareness, strength, and didn't allow all the difficulties to kill my dreams. I found myself in a life as challenging as a raging ocean. I realized that this suffering and my suffering and everyone's suffering in this world is man-made. And this is where hope begins, because it's man-made. I am a person of faith. I know God wants every good thing for us. I can't challenge God, but I can challenge someone who's doing bad thing by not accepting it, by taking responsibility. And I want to tell you, as Mahmoud Darwish, the Palestinian poet, said, he who looks at the sea doesn't know the sea. He who sits on the shore doesn't know the sea. Only he who immerses himself, dives, takes risks, and forgets the sea in the sea. I believe there is no greater challenge than the lack of personal responsibility. Taking personal responsibility transcends the circumstances and situation in which we live and find ourselves. One of the most important ingredients for moving forward is the knowledge of what exactly you want and making plan on how to achieve it, whatever the challenges and whatever others are saying. Always, I say to you as a graduate student, always to listen to your inner voice. Do it, take it. I learned to listen to my inner voice and to follow what it says. Don't say no. After you try, then you can decide if you want to say no. Always to remember you have within you the strength and the patience to reach for the stars, to change the world. I learned as a physician what life and death actually mean when a person dies. I learned to value all life immensely and to realize that others have needs and sufferings that I wanted to alleviate through my work as a physician, to defend humanity and to understand that human beings and the freedom are the most holy things in the universe. I saw the hope in the newborn baby I delivered. I was the first Palestinian doctor to practice medicine in an Israeli hospital, because medicine, health, have one face, one culture, one value. It's a human face, value, and culture. Medicine and health are the human equalizer and stabilizer. My happiest moment when I handled the baby to his mother. There is no difference in the cry of the newborn baby. Whether a Muslim, Jewish, a Christian, a Druze, it's a cry of a new hope. But at the same time, I saw the killing of my beloved daughters. These beautiful, bright daughters, in a sudden, they became barbs, drowning in their blood. But from that moment, I saw them. I swore to God and swore to my daughters, I will never rest, I will never give up, I will never forget them, because I believe I will meet them one day. And I want to meet them with the big gift. It's the justice for them and for others in this world, and not to allow others to be killed or to suffer in this world, but which means to be used. That's what we learned, and that's what do we want to practice in our life. Is it the bullet or the shell? The bullet is the weapon of the weak. You have today stronger means. It's the wisdom you are learning. It's the kind, courageous words and the good deeds, and that's what is needed for our world. For those who endure suffering, loss and tyranny, hope is the remedy. Medicine and health are needed in our world. The world in which we live is endemic with violence, injustice, fear, and hatred. And these diseases are not limited to one geographical area. They cross barriers, and we all are impacted directly or indirectly by them. And we live, all of us, we live in a small world, and no one is far from risk, and we all are impacted by it. I wrote my book, I Shall Not Hate, because the people were expecting me to be drowning in an ocean of hatred. And someone may see that resilience and tolerance are weakness, and silence is a defeat, but they don't know that resilience and tolerance need greater power of that needed for revenge, and that silence is more powerful than words. The great Lebanese poet Khalil Gibran once said, tenderness and kindness are not signs of weakness and despair, but manifestations of strength and resolution. I refused to fall a victim to despair, and instead vowed to fight for all, regardless of religious or political beliefs, and in particular to fight for reconciliation, peace, and justice between Palestinians and Israelis and in our world. I fully believe words are stronger than bullets. Even if words can't stop bullets, they can deflect the poisonous hatred resulting from these bullets. Peace is a dangerous idea to those who invested in violence. A refusal to hate is the most powerful weapon in the arsenal of a human experience and the transformation. I succeeded in my life, but I will never forget from where did I come. From Jabalia camp, to Cairo University, to London, to Italy, to Belgium, to Harvard. Everything in life I planned, I succeeded to achieve. I wasn't born with a golden spoon, but I was determined with my faith, in my faith and in God and in myself, to achieve, and that nothing is impossible in life. Everything in life is possible. The only impossible thing in life I believe in is to return my beloved daughters back. But I am determined to keep them alive in your minds, in your hearts, in your souls, with good deeds. So don't forget, from where did you come? Did you ever forget your community? Don't forget your parents who invested much in you. Give back to these people. They are waiting for you to save them, to rescue them. The more you give, the more you will be rewarded. And I learned from my children that I am proud of. I have two of them. I have Shada and Abdullah. And Shada alone, her journey inspires and drives me. She refused to be a victim, and education was her way out. And she proved that the antidote to hate and revenge is to learn from our children that there is one road map to humanity, peace, and success, and this is through education. Shada, who is sitting here, she was studying day and night during the war to be one of the top 10 in Palestine in the high school. And what she suffered in 4 months, mountains can tolerate it. 16th of September 2000, she lost her mother of acute leukemia. Then 16th of January 2009, 3 sisters and niece were killed and she was severely wounded. And she was treated at the hospital I am working at in Israel. After 4 months, she lost the sight in one eye with 2 malformed fingers in her right hand. She said, I have to go to achieve the plans of my sisters. I will never be defeated. I will never be broken. And that's what we need to teach, not to be broken or be defeated and to give up. She did the high school exam in Palestine, which is a standardized national exam for the whole country at the same moment, irrelative to what did you pass through. The day we moved to Canada, they announced the result in the radio. And she was worried. I didn't worry about Shada, and I didn't give much care to it. I gave much care to her health. And the moment they announced her name, that she succeeded 96%, as nothing happened to her. And 16th of June 2015, she graduated from the School of Engineering at the University of Toronto. That's the message we need to learn from our children, that there is an alternative way not to be a victim. Don't accept to be a victim in life more than once, to take responsibility. And you need to ask yourself, what kind of people must you be? You must be people of values, vision, and leadership. Values include respect for human dignity and social justice. You must promote these values and live your life by these values with passion, courage, and persistence. We must show that life is precious and that none is ignored or considered unworthy of a secure and a prosperous life. You need to be leaders who translate these values and vision into actions. Don't underestimate or reject yourself. The first step in failure is to lose confidence in yourself and to reject yourself. Always, as I said, to listen to your inner voice. Do it, take it, don't say no. In memory of my daughters, and because in my life I am in debt to my mother, my wife, and my daughters, and the tragedy can't be the end of our lives. We can't allow it to control and defeat us. In memory of my daughters, I established Daughters for Life Foundation for education of young girls and women from the Middle East, irrelative to their background, whether Palestinians, Israelis, Jordanians, Syrians, Lebanese. It's about young women, about humans. It's about humanity, because I fully believe this world can endure. And to be a peaceful, a free world, it's only by investing in women's education and giving the women the right role and the opportunity. It's time to try and to invest in women's education and to give them the right role and opportunity. And you are here to learn and see the truth and act to bring justice. Education is the strongest agent for progress, change, and prosperity. You came to learn, to be enlightened, and see things differently, and enlarge your universe. Education is about creating a world of justice and hope and eradicate injustice. Daughters for Life walks the talk and transcends borders, ethnicity, and religion. And I am looking for the day to see young women from Daughters for Life joining the commencement graduations of Brock University to spread the Canadian message that we are global and we are human and we impact the world. One can do everything, but each of us can do something. Today, you are graduates and you are the next generation of leaders, and it's you who will have to bring fresh ideas and solutions to the world. Challenges, now it's your turn, and we have to handle the torch and the baton to you. Congratulations again. I came here because I believe in you, and I feel I am one of you. Right now, you are the hope, the new blood, and the new leaders with the new vision. Go in confidence with faith and hope. And without fear, the world is waiting for you. Tomorrow is yours and is hopeful because of you. Thank you, and God bless you.
Graduates, it's time to graduate. Will the candidates for the various degrees and certificates please rise? With the degrees and certificates about to be conferred upon you, there comes a certain expectation that you will continue sincerely in the pursuit of learning and truth, and that as far as in you lies, you will promote the interests and welfare of your university. Do you acknowledge this expectation? Yeah. Madam Chancellor, as the candidates have acknowledged the responsibilities that accompany their degrees and certificates, and as they have successfully completed the courses of study prescribed by Senate, I would ask that you admit them to their several degrees and certificates.
I admit you. Please be seated.
Congratulations.
Madam Chancellor, I have the honor to present these candidates to receive a Doctor of Philosophy.
Kirk Stokes. Stefan Van Noort, recipient of the Jack M. Miller Excellence in Research Award for Psychology.
Madam Chancellor, it is my honor to ask Brock's newest PhD graduates to take a seat on the stage with their colleagues. Madam Chancellor, I have the honor to present these candidates to receive a Master of Applied Disability Studies.
Riley Hannah Elizabeth Aitken, Olivia Anwender, Libby Ann Louise Attell, Jessica Nicole Bryant, Sophia Marie Catania, Preet Chana, Ziyan Chun, Kylie Elizabeth Schmiel, Aaron Lawrence Chung, Amanda June Coulthard, Brianna DeRoche, Melissa Dewar, Talitha Dykstra, Melissa Enns, Kelsey Ferguson, Krista Fitzsimmons, Alicia Gagne, Lisa Nicole Gache, Melissa Gilroy, Salima Halani, Jennifer Hall, Faye Harper, Jennifer Christine Hawking, Elizabeth Welina Hutchinson, Thakshila Jaratna, Aditi Sarah Joseph, Alexandra Jotham, Leon Judy, Holly Kehoe, Ruby Khan, Lena Coley, Eva Maria Latanzio, Melinda Dawn Lipsky, Karen Manuel, Vanessa Marsman, Lauren Martell, Lauren McDonald, Catherine McHugh, Caitlin Louisa McNeil, recipient of the Distinguished Graduate Student Award for Applied Disability Studies, Helen Merrick, Deanna Minervini, Aubrey Mosher, Fatima Nawaz, Kura Niang, Raluca Nutza, Kathleen O'Connor, Sherry Shumi Chin, Jessica Regis, Jessica Marie Richards, Ana Luisa Loro Santo. Isabel Silvera, Annette Carol Sims. Simone Marie Sulum, Lauren Sugar. Lakshmi Thayaparan, Jessica Wesley. Sarah Joanne Westalakin, Anne Michelle Wormald. Shelly Yusufov.
Madam Chancellor, I have the honor to present these candidates to receive a Master of Arts.
Mame Echa Agiman, Mohammed Razu Ahmed. Arwa Alamri, William Sarfo Ankoma. Jacob Jimmy Ashimadi, Felix Obeng Asuming, Atik Awan, Michael Iyer K. IRT, recipient of the Distinguished Graduate Student Award for Geography. Nicole Berry, Jennifer Beauvais. Woo! Antwi Boasiaki, recipient of the Spirit of Brock Medal. Alan Campopiano, recipient of the Distinguished Graduate Student Award for Psychology. Ashley Nicole Couillard, Allison Margaret Drake. Ryan Forster, Caitlin Gibson. Christopher Scott Grayway, recipient of the Distinguished Graduate Student Award for Critical Sociology, Whitney Kerr. Kate Eileen McDonald, Samantha Grace McNeil. Diana Oasua, Cassandra Robinson. Paolo Russomano, Peter Sacher. Cody Daniel Vinay, Rebecca Lynn Voss, recipient of the Distinguished Graduate Student Award for Applied Linguistics.
Okay. Madam Chancellor, I have the honor to present these candidates to receive a Master of Business Economics.
Corey Jonathan Carlton, recipient of the Distinguished Graduate Student Award for Business Economics. Omolola Fowler. Grace Obakoma Kumsen, Bradley James Rawson. Mikhail Susan, Anna Veselovska. Hao Yang Zhang.
Madam Chancellor, I have the honor to present these candidates to receive a Master of Sustainability Studies.
Erin Elizabeth Duffy, Brody Terrence Haig, Sarah Maxine Holmes, Christine Marie Jansen. Samantha Morris, recipient of the Distinguished Graduate Student Award for Sustainability, Science, and Society. Samantha Stia.
Madam Chancellor, I have the honor to present these candidates to receive a Bachelor of Arts honors.
Nemi Wisdom Adoki, Sandra Agudosi. Nicholas Santo Aiello, Matthew Francesco Alampi. Nicholas Michael Alessi. Zakria Saad Alabad. Alexia Anastasopoulos with first class standing. Katerina Ivana Bago. Megan Cindy Lauren Barty with first class standing. Brianna Lynn Bettel. Misak Massis Bellion, Amanda Bertucci. Julie Lynn Bolton with first class standing. Brett Ryan Book with first class standing. Annika Riley Bossi with first class standing. Allison Jill Bunader. Carly Elizabeth Braley. Jason Robert Michael Brown with first class standing. Sarah Ashley Berger. Sean Joseph Calcott with first class standing. Alicia Christina Carvalho with first class standing. Brianna Marie Catu. John Michael Chesham, Colin Charles Christmas.
It's not Clarky.
Please go ahead. Kayla Marie Clark, Samantha Clark. Eric Cleary, Jennifer Michelle Collins with first class standing. Emily Sarah Coombs with first class standing. Luke Alexander Cormier with first class standing. Jamie Corrales. Elena Marie Costanzo with first class standing. Christopher Courtnage, Sarah Elizabeth Cowie with first class standing. Stephen Dean Arthur Curtis with first class standing. Michael Spencer Dalio with first class standing. Luca Alessandro Damiano with first class standing. Alexandra Sarah Davis. Maria de la Pava, Rebecca Diana. Cameron John Dobbelstein, Kaylee Jean Francis Doyle. Tibiso Drametu, Haley Duckworth. Jessica Grace Dykstra with first class standing. Joy Edial with first class standing. Alessandra Carnero, Brendan Matthew Ellingham. Kara Lee Emberson, Heidi Lausanne Epp. Nicholas James Everett, Armando Falatico. Nicole Ann Ferguson with first class standing. Cole Robert Fernie. Chelsea Lee Fields with first class standing. Celine Marguerite Louise Filion. Christina Francia. Ellen Nicole Freeman with first class standing. William Friedel Roberts. Alexandra Marie Galvin with first class standing. James Alexander Gardner with first class standing. Courtly Garty Johnson. Alexis Gillies. Ethan John William Gillis. Ivan Gonzalez Ivan Gonsalves Almasi. Luca Grancerek with first class standing. Matthew Green. Denise Emily Hamilton with first class standing. Patrick Joseph Harrison. Vanessa Mary Hartwick. Amanda Hassan Ali. Kathy Jean Hayward Young. Justin Christopher Hedden. Cassandra Jordan Marie Hess with first class standing. Maria Nicole Hill. Taylor Mariah Hill. Alexander Michael Hobbs with first class standing, recipient of the Purple Chair Award. Kelsey Ann Holmes. Emily Hariblin, Xiaowei Hua. Angelica Serafina Yanucci. Katerina Evelyn Ayapico with first class standing. Deanna Marie Irwin. Donna Jones. Jasmine Candela, Ashley Ann Marie Kasoyan with first class standing. Madison Kelly, Jamal Nathaniel Kelly Russell. Kylie Lynn Kilburn, Alexandra Mary Kempinski. Cassandra Katrina Kovacic, Sierra Linnea Kramer, Sabrina Teresa Kwan, Stephanie La Civita, Ryan Michael Laird, Jade Lalonde, Christine Learmonth, Kevin Lee with first class standing. Rebecca Margaret Lefebvre, Rebecca Suzanne Lepore with first class standing, recipient of the Spirit of Brock Medal, the Dean's Medal, and the President's Sergite Award. Ming Chi Li, Qiu Yu Liao. Julia Alexandra List with first class standing. Daniel Joseph Levecki with first class standing. Sophie Laureus with first class standing. Allison McDonald. Grace Elizabeth Maish with first class standing. Jody Elizabeth Manchuk. Laura Ashley Mannon, Brian Howard Medwid. Brittany Christina Melton, Rachel Alexandra Moore with first class standing. Patrick Morris with first class standing. Ira Mohammed Noor. Jordan Marie Mullins with first class standing. Stephanie Elizabeth Murray with first class standing. Recipient of the Distinguished Graduating Student Award, Bachelor of Arts Geography, the Canadian Association of Geographers Book Prize, and the Department of Geography Graduating Prize. Jad Nasser, Sarah Nasso. Angela Nlovu, Jessica Victoria Neufeld. James Jeffrey Newland, Christian William Ninnis. Kyle Thomas Nixon, Catrice Nolan. Anne Marie Francois Norman with first class standing. Marilyn Obasaki.
Susan Uche Odega, Carlisle O. Karina Barbara Olasevich, Shannon Elizabeth O'Rourke with first class standing. Aaron Otten, John George Pappas with first class standing. Jordan Alicia Peach with first class standing, recipient of the Political Science Department Year 4 Book Prize. Miranda Leslie Pemberton. Heather Marie Peters. Carly Elise Polito. Morgan Emily Potts. Karine Poulin. Michael Anthony Prattis, with first class standing, recipient of the Dr. James A. Gibson Book Prize in Political Science. Cassandra Kelly Priest, with first class standing. Jessica Lee Prudence. Michael Romano. Kendra Scapatici. Antonio Dominic Sergi. Lauren Kate Ashley Seriani, with first class standing. Cody Jordan Shelley McKay. Michael Coleman Sibbins. Megan Rebecca Smiley. Lauren Nicole Marie Summers, with first class standing. Esther Stanley. Samantha Stewart, Caitlin Audrey Shepanowski, Angelo Francis Tegarelli, Jacob Aaron Leaf Detesco, Brittany Terryberry, Danielle Beverly Thompson, Monica Rose Tinholt with first class standing. David James Thompson. Celeste Daniela Torres. Ashley Lynn Trudel. Gata Dinesh Vadher. Jonathan Valancourt with first class standing, recipient of the Dean's Award for Good Writing and the Distinguished Graduating Student Award from Popular Culture. Tina Elizabeth van der Linden with first class standing, recipient of the Outstanding Contribution to Business Communication Award. Victoria Diane Vassy. Elizabeth Julia Vay. Stephanie Melissa Villers with first class standing. Amanda Justine Vedums. Jessica Wainman. Francesco Watson. Sarah Elizabeth Weiss. Emma Louise Westley, Luke Witte, Tessa Leone Esmeralda Willebrand, Jeremy Wong, Dana Wright, Madison Janelle Ewell. Nikki Christina Zay with first class standing, recipient of the Distinguished Graduating Student Award for Applied Linguistics. Yichen Zhan. Jason Thomas Peter DiBiase.
Madam Chancellor, I have the honor to present these candidates to receive a Bachelor of Arts with major.
Tai Agbabiaka, Rachel Alexandra Bachelor. Nicholas Alfred Bowden, Laura Ann Beaton Williamson. Megan Francis Carr, Jordana Louise Cookman. Isabel Marie Cote Clamp, Crezana De Silva. Suhela Fenrereda, Casey Ferniehow. Harley William Norman Fitzsimons, Carly Nicole Green. Matthew Anthony Garashi, Rachel Josephine Hall. Yeah, I know. Brianna Knox, Taylor Jade Marie Lewis. Taylor Michael McLeod, Laura Jean McRae, Narelle Ratanshaw Mehta, Tyler Molyneux, Stephanie Mulder, Nikiruka Antonia Offor. Sydney Elaine O'Neill, Nikita Elizabeth Peshkovich, Jade Mariah Parsons, Francesca Gianna Testa with distinction, Alexia Watson,
Madam Chancellor, I have the honor to present these candidates to receive a Bachelor of Arts 3-year.
Emro Abdulbaki, Lucas Samuel Agro. Shamya Emolohi Egebu, pardon me, let me try that one more time. Shama Emolohi Egbinode. Fatim Al-Bakami, Nafa Al-Bakami, Sasha Amir Goli, Anisha Bakshi, Vijeta Bahardwaj, Alana Grace Brond, Nick Robert Burrows. Joshua Butcher, Won Ji Chun. Jessica Marie Chetterbuck, Kevin James Clutterbuck. Nicholas. Not too far. Nicholas Da Silva, Corey Tyler Dano. Pardon me, Dano. Aaliyah Davidson, Emmalise Degenkamp. Bryant Robert Dorsum, Nicole Evelyn Donatelli. Jing Jing Dong, Kevin Andrew Duckett. Rebecca Ann Farthing, Jinan Fung. Anita Maureen Foran with distinction, Gorana Geich. Gorana Geich. Yan Jing Dong Gao, Yi Gao. Zijuan Gao, Emily Garrett. Jordan Tyrell Gale, Enya Shanice Gentile. Jennifer Rose Giancaterino, Boris Godsinevsky, Nicola Krishan Gritani, Ruo Chanhan, Michael Stephen Hart, Aaron Harvey, John Thomas Hornby, Justin Connor Horner, Stephen John Douglas Hume, Apirami Indrakumar, Brittany Marie Johnston, Nicholas Christopher Kawa. Haley Ann Kirkpatrick, Jenna Lindsay Kirkwood, David Kremner, Courtney Cromer, Tia Jeanette Catheri Cooling, Christopher Lancaster, Sophie Lapierre, Su Lok Lau, Sarah Elizabeth LeMay, Colleen Rosalie Leslie, Vinci Lap Tak Leong, Wei Hao Liu. Farai Brian McConey, Cole Taylor McDonald, Michael Andrew McDonald, Brandon McLean, Amelia Rose McMenemy, Brianne McMillan, Ling Jun Meng, Xian Yu Meng, Christina Mikhalkova, Michael Molnar, Joel Alexander Moore Delaney, Kalina May Offenhammer, Shirley Oforiado, Ashley Victoria Parker Rogers, Lee Wan Run, Mitchell Robertson, Sylvia Mariana Rodriguez, Lauren Marie Christine Roy Davis, Guong Yao Wu, Rehan Sajwani, Anthony Skornayanki, Yi Tong Shi, Michael Crawford Sinclair, Kirsten Scoobel, Benjamin Stubbs, Dan Xin Sun, Yuan Yuan Sun, Craig Allen Swanson, Sean Tollefson, Alyssa May Erbschott, Paula Useche Hernandez, Cole Vinay, Guong Hao Wang, Hai Zhou Wang, Tung Wong, Zhong Yi Wong, Michael Adam Waters, Abby Lee White, Jessica Kathleen Whittle, Leonard James Williams, Brett Andrew Wilson, Nan Xiao, Ying Xiong, Gu Chen Yin, Hung Yin, Amir Zair, Jia Zhang, Min Zhang,
Madam Chancellor, I have the honor to present these candidates to receive a Bachelor of Business Economics.
Mohammed Abu El Saad, Najib Abro, Adil Mustafa Ahmad, Isakan Biobel Akpata with first class standing, James Thomas Allen Brownbridge, Saab Singh Kunar with first class standing, recipient of the Distinguished Graduating Student Award for Business Economics. Tsungguang Li, Hang Li, Naomi Ruth McCapagal, Manal Sajia with first class standing. Lindsay Mary Shippers, Ya Tian Sun. Xiao Duan Wang, Hui Xian Wen, Heng Yi Zhu, Austin Yung,
Madam Chancellor, I have the honor to present these candidates to receive a Bachelor of Science honors and a Bachelor of Science 3-year.
Beatrice Beshi, Kenneth Makoto Chapman, Sarah Louise Loisel, Angela Christine Mott with first class standing, recipient of the Distinguished Graduating Student Award for the Bachelor of Science in Geography. Stephanie Page Pratt, Ryan Alexander Roque, Jennifer Lynn Schultz, Caitlin Alice Jean Smith,
congratulations.
Madam Chancellor, I have the honor to present these candidates to receive a certificate in speech and language sciences.
Stephen Guyrie.
Madam Chancellor, whereas certain candidates who have successfully completed the course of studies prescribed by Senate are absent from this convocation for just cause, I request that you confer upon them their degrees and certificates in absentia.
I admit them to their several degrees and certificates in absentia.
Madam Chancellor, the Senate of Brock University has recommended awarding of a Dean's Medal to the graduate in each faculty with the highest standing in a first honors degree. I take great pleasure in inviting Rebecca Lepore to come forward to accept this award.
Greetings, fellow alumni, Chancellor Chichu, Dr. Lightstone, Dr. Abulish. As a member of the executive of the Brock University Alumni Association, an alumnus from political science in 2004 and education in 2005, I am pleased to congratulate all of you who received your degree this afternoon. You are now all alumni. And what does it mean to be alumni? As of this morning, you now join a network of over 90,000 other graduates, those who are willing to connect with you, work with you, mentor you, and advocate for you in your personal growth and in your professional development. The value of your degree is a reflection of the success all of our alumni have had in their careers and in their personal lives. Our alumni are making positive marks in the world, and that impact raises the value of your degree. But don't just take my word for it. Here are some special messages from other Brock alumni.
Congratulations, and welcome to the Brock University Alumni Association. As you embark on your journey as Brock alumni, you will be joining a network of over 90,000 fellow graduates from all over the world.
This is the first day of the rest of your life, and your Alumni Association is here for you every step of the way as you go out into the world and maximize the value of a Brock degree.
Make sure you keep us up to date on where life takes you, professionally, socially, your growing family, and personal achievements. We want to celebrate you.
As a Brock Badger, you receive discounts on everything from home and auto insurance to sporting event tickets.
Don't forget to take advantage of your alumni discount at the campus store so you can continue to wear your Badger gear with pride.
Tap into the privileges of being a Brock alumni and update your contact information.
We'll keep you up to date on all the upcoming events in your area, alumni benefits, and on-campus news.
No matter where you land after convocation, your alumni chapter volunteers are always planning to help keep you connected through networking opportunities, professional development, and exciting events both on and off campus. Yeah, that's my son.
So let's make a toast to the past years of laughs and tears, struggles and triumphs, the friends you made, and the memories that will last you a lifetime. We'll see you at homecoming for your year one reunion.
The Brock University Alumni Association is honored to welcome you. As you start this new chapter in your lives, see yourselves as ambassadors of your university. Share your Brock experience with others, and be sure to share your successes with us. Be in touch with us often, and be as proud of your university as we are of you. Take what you've learned at Brock, go out in the world and improve it. Push on and experience your life to the fullest. Sergite.
Well, we've come to the end of convocation. How does it feel to have graduated? Family and friends of the graduates, how does it feel to have watched them graduate? Well, I know that my last few remarks on our national anthem are separating you from celebration, so I will be very brief. You've just heard from the representative of the Alumni Association that you are now lifelong alumni, lifelong members of the Alumni Association, and it's my obligation to tell you that this is a club from which you can never resign. And in fact, generations of alumni, I've said this too over the past 10 years, you and your university, you alumni and your alma mater have a lifelong symbiotic relationship. Why? Because your success in life from the day you leave this building will reflect on your university and add value to the degrees of students who have not yet even arrived here to follow their studies. And our future success as an institution of higher learning and research will continue to add value to your degrees in the many days and years that follow today. So, remember us well and keep in touch with us. And know that if you do not keep in touch with us, we will keep in touch with you. You have benefited from the involvement of those who graduated before you in this university, and you benefited in the classrooms and the facilities you used from their continued engagement after graduation. And the students who will be entering this university should expect of you, the graduates of today, the same level of engagement and association with this university so that they will benefit from your future engagement. Finally, from all of us who work at Brock, our heartfelt congratulations, and we wish you all success in the many days and years that follow today. So congratulations. In a moment, I will invite everyone to rise for the singing of our national anthem. But in a moment. But I want to remind all of you that you are all welcome outside in the tent for refreshments. There's a tent outside this building to my right, to your left. However, I want all of the family and friends, after the singing of our national anthem, to remain in their seats until first the platform party and then the graduates have recessed in procession from the hall, and then you can all find one another outside. You may leave this hall, after family and friends, after the procession, by either using the doors behind you or using the doors behind me. And let me give you some advice. The doors behind me are the shortest route from here to the reception and the refreshments. So please rise for the singing of our national anthem. I declare this convocation dismissed. Mm-hmm.